Hey everybody, this is your friendly host, Shadow White Tiger, coming at you. So we're here today, we're gonna start a new game, Kingdom Hearts 1, Final Mix. So, I'm gonna go over some things during it. We're just gonna play this on standard, you know. Don't wanna play proud mode off rip. Especially for any of those of you who may be watching this for the first time. I hope you're able to enjoy. So, let's let it rip, shall we? Enjoy the story.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
I apologize for that little blip in the corner. I was also installing 2.8. Okay. So, as you all know, if you've looked up anything ever about this game, you know, your first choice is your weapon, which can dictate how you grow in the game. Not a lot of people understand on how the stats work when you're doing so. So, you know, a lot of people, because, you know, they think, oh yeah, I need attack stat to really do damage. And that's not incorrect, but at the same time, it's not 100% accurate. A lot of times, you need magic with the first title. The first title is more about your magic than it is your actual attack stat. But, myself, I'm more of a hands-on kind of guy, so I'm gonna go with the sword, which will leave the sword and shield to be sacrificed. So, the sword will give you a higher attack stat off-rip. If you prefer more magic, then the staff is where you want to go. Having the defense... So, what little people know is, depending on what weapon you choose, it kind of dictates how many maximum item slots you get by the end of the game. So, like, if you go staff, you can have 6. If you go sword, 7. If you go shield, you can have 8. Now, let's say if you go shield and sacrifice sword, you will be able to have 4 strength, 4 defense, 2 stats in your MP, and 3 in your AP. However, if you want to go the magic route, the better bet would be, like, go choose staff and give up sword. That will give you 3 points across the board of strength, defense, MP, and AP. However, if you want the stronger strength stat but want to give up your defense, staff, and then sacrifice shield. Now, if you do, like I said, I'm going to do sword. This is the power I seek, right? Now, that'll give me a starting attack stat of 6, no matter which way I give up. And I'm going to also choose to sacrifice, if I can get up here. Come on. There we go. I'm going to sacrifice the power of the Guardian, which is the shield. This will give me 6 strength, but only 1 point in defense. This will give me 2 magic and 3 AP. Now, if I went the other way and gave up the staff, I would have had 6, 2, 2, and 1 instead of 6, 1, 2, and 3. Now, AP means a lot in this game because that's your ability points. So being able to have the 3 AP points is really critical depending on how you want to do it. With the sword, no matter what, you will have 2 MP. It's just the defense will be 1 point higher or not, you know. Like I said, if you want stronger stats, like I said, you could do shield, give up staff, and you'll have 5, 4, 2, and 1. But to have the better AP would be the shield, sword, and then you'll have 4, 4, 2, and 3. And you'll have 8 item slots. But it all depends on your playstyle of how you want to do it, you know? And depending on what you choose right here for your starting weapon is basically what you'll have to fight through the tutorial and whatnot. Yes, half a juice. So now all that crumbles away. Now, I will say if you're playing on proud mode, then your best bet would be choosing the shield and sacrificing the staff. This will allow you to get the abilities Guard, Leaf Bracer, and Second Chance, I believe, earlier than normal. That's another thing, is depending on your path, it can dictate what you learn a little bit quicker than others. So, like, picking the sword, you will get to learn your combo abilities faster over learning your supporting ones. You know, same thing with magic, you'll be able to pick up on, like, MP plus and things like that faster. Eh, I got hit. Oh well. That tells you about the EXP orbs. Items. Sorry if I'm going through this a little too quick. behind you. Gradually, you'll generally, you'll automatically target the nearest enemy. Basically, it tells you about lock on. You can lock on, lock off, if you want to run away. Now, we do still have some other choices that we have to do, which will kind of dictate our growth. And I'll explain those once we get to that point. Oh no, I'm falling! Wait, I'm not falling. What? Come on, Sora, get your butt up. So now we learn about doors and whatnot. The action command. I can't open it. It's not solid. Well, no crap, you genius. Ooh, treasure chest. What's that? Use the action command to do various things. Who thinks to really open a chest by tapping on it with a sword? Like, I would be trying to open that with my hands, you know? So, you can push a crate. Tells us about that. Come on. It's supposed to prompt me. There you go. And you can also smash it. Get an item. You use that with the item on it. Hey, part of the door became physical. You can also lock on to items and switch between them using L2. Oh, you can also pick up. They don't want to say anything about that. Hey, where'd my barrel go? I wanted to smash it. Oh well. Moving on. Let the door to your destiny open. Oh wait, I forgot to tell you. The door won't open just yet. Let's tell you more about ourselves. So, I mean, you can get a better view by touching the touchpad. Unfortunately, you can't really move around in it. So, yeah, you can press triangle. It's your action command, you know, talk to people. The questions these guys are going to ask, this is what's going to dictate your EXP growth in the game. So, talk to this. What are you afraid of, you know? The first option with all three of them will let you grow quickly from levels 1 through 50. But your grind from level 51 to 99 is going to be slow. If you pick the middle options with all three, your EXP growth will be constant or consistent. If you pick the bottom option, the third option with all three, your growth from 1 through 50 will be slow. However, once you hit 51 going up to 99, it will be a lot easier. So that's what we're going to go with. The third option. So being indecisive, is that really so scary? Be strong! You know? And what's the most important? My prized possessions. Such a big deal. So being indecisive, being strong, and collect neat things, you know? Because we're that selfish. Adventure begins in the dead of night. The road won't be easy, but a rising sun awaits your journey's end. Sounds good to me. Let's go. Did They will open doors both far off and very near. And now we're back here. So we've done Snow White, we've done Cinderella, now we're on Sleeping Beauty. Does this about a main menu, inventory, and stuff like that. But you can't open it during battle. It just pauses the battle. Trying not to take too many hits here. Look, you little... There. Battle over. And now we learn about saves. Kingdom Hearts 1, it completely heals you. And the path forward becomes illuminated. So we'll go ahead and save real quick. I'll create a new save for you guys. I started up a new file on my own. I'm already an hour into it. I'm about to basically leave the first area. So we'll start this on file 4. So now that we're out of battle, we now have access to all this, right? But we ain't got nothing to do with that at the moment. We don't have any extra items or anything. Fortunately, there's no dash, there's no rolling. There's no way to really move quicker. Here we are. Belle. From Beauty and the Beast. Closer you get to the light, the greater your shadow becomes. Anti-Sora, don't be afraid. And don't forget. You cannot run or hide from the darkness. Now this battle, you can draw out a bit. Or you can just beat the living crap out of him. We're gonna try to draw out this battle just a little bit to get some extra experience points. Yeah, no, I'm taking hits over here. You don't want to be there when he slams his fist down. Go ahead and get back some of our health that we've lost. This truck's just outside of range. as you see, if you hit those, you can actually get checkpoints, which help later on. Some of your little heartless. See? See, because the first 50 levels we're leveling up is going to be such a grind, this is a good way to get an advantage off rip. After we leave the beginning area. And I just ended the battle, but whatever. I gained at least one level off of it. I could have dragged it out a little longer, but that's fine. Be afraid. You hold the mightiest weapon. So don't forget. You are the one who will open the door. I feel that.
Whoa!
Give me a break, Kyrie.
Sorry, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yes, sure.
Say, Kyrie, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you know this. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh?
What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
And they fell for the trap. And thus begins. Or does it? Only one way to find out. Destiny Island. Even though it's only one island. Yeah, I heard ya. You need two logs, a cloth, and a rope. Alright, so... A lot of this stuff's gonna be easy to find. Log number one. Open around here. There's our cloth. Over here is going to be our rope. Lock number two. Oh, right. So I go into the shack here. There's a save point. Lock number two is right here. Now, you can immediately go back to Kyrie, turn all that in, and move forward with the story. Or, what I'm about to do. We have Waka here, Tidus is up there, and Selfie is right there. For those of you, small tidbit of trivia, Tidus and Waka from Final Fantasy X, or Final Fantasy X, and Selfie here is from Final Fantasy VIII, or VIII. Now, you get one experience point for beating Waka, one experience point for beating Selfie, or 2 points for beating Tidus. So I'll demonstrate each of these fights
real quick. Hey, what's happening, man? Show me your stuff!
Ha! Now, if you got patience, you can do this without taking a hit. I think there was a trophy for it, I don't remember. If you get too close, he will whack you, so be careful about that. Oh well. There goes the doing it without taking a hit. Yeah, I don't care right now. I'm gonna take my hit. It's something like 20 hits, I think.
I win!
Look here, we're gonna try that again.
Show me your stuff!
Look here, I wanna poke you with my stick. There we go, that's three. Six. Okay, well there goes without it. Nine. Twelve. Really? Eighteen. I think. Not right. There we go. So 21.
Oh man, that really hurt.
1 point.
Great.
She's a little easier because she isn't quite as aggressive. But her attacks are a little more wide range. There you go. Did that one without getting hit.
Oh, I can't believe I lost.
She does have an attack where she will follow you for a few seconds, swinging around the rope, and there'll be no way to touch her. So you be careful if you attempt it. All right. Next up, we have Peetus.
Hey, Sora. You feel lucky today?
Let's go!
You're going down!
Oop. Oh well, that goes without a hit.
Come on!
He's easy enough if you know what you're doing, but yeah, he can hit you pretty good. So like that back flip you keep seeing him do, if you stay in close too long, he jumps back at you. Come on, it's your last hit. Or not.
Oh man, I'm really off today.
And this is repeatable, you can keep fighting him and gain some experience points. I get 7 more points, so why not, you know? Now, after you've fought all three of them and won, you can fight all three of them. If you're feeling cocky, it's a bigger experience point, so it is a little more challenging, so be careful. If you take too many hits. See, there's that whip follow that she likes to do. So as you see, it's more challenging when you're fighting all three of them. There's that tech point that adds up as experience points, so there's one. Now these two can be a challenge if you're not careful.
You ready?
Take this. Oh. Hey you guys, I think we overdid it.
But the whole point was is I got experience enough to level up. So you can repeat that as many times as you want. I'm not gonna bother because my whole point was to level up. So now we're gonna go back and see Kyrie. Hey, Sora. I found something good. What is it? Stories. Yeah, let's go ahead and call it a day.
So, Kyrie's home is out there somewhere, right?
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far could a raft take us?
Who knows? If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds. then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kairi, thanks.
You're welcome.
Sora! You wanted one, didn't you?
A Paopu fruit?
If two people share one, their destinies become intertwined. They'll remain a part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking...
Disney Castle. How on earth am I supposed to open such a large dang door? Oh, that's how. I said, wake up!
Hey there, Donald! Good morning!
We've got a problem, Dookie. But don't tell anyone.
Ooh. Queen Minnie?
Not even the queen!
Daisy?
No! It's top secret!
Oh, good morning, ladies!
What?
Oh, crap. What was that about top secret? Meanwhile, back on Destiny Island.
Hey, Sora. Have you heard about the legendary power of the Paopu fruit? They say if you share it with someone you really care for, it binds you together forever and ever, through eternity. It's so romantic. I gotta try it sometime.
She got like that cat-like smile. So weird.
Me and Titus, we are gonna do a little exploring today. You know, to the secret place at the base of that tree. There's gotta be something there, yeah?
Alright, we'll check that out in a sec, but let's go talk to Titus first.
Stronger,
but odds are you're still no match for Riku. We took him on 3-1 last time, and he whipped us all. Well, I guess Kairi can always count on him.
Maybe, maybe not. So, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna go back here first. And that causes us to fall. Cool, found a mushroom. Raft's almost ready. All we need now is load it with food. Maybe some reaper. Alright, so now we can actually collect some food stuff real quick. Move this boulder. Another mushroom in there. I don't remember exactly how many there is lying around this place. I know there was something, at least about 3 or 4 mushrooms, like 2 eggs. Back out here. And don't think there's anything up here. Let's collect a fish, I think. Yep. Where'd you go? I know I saw another fish. There we go. So now we got some fish. You can swim a little quicker by tapping circle. So that's kind of helpful for that. Ah, dang it. Oh, come on, climb it. So we're gonna climb up here. Not sure which one of these trees have it. If any of them... Ah, crap! Let's see. I'm not seeing a seagull egg up there. So, we're gonna move on over here. This right there is a seagull egg. Got that egg now. Alright, now that we've done all that, we're gonna jump on down here. We're gonna head back here. To our secret place. Check out a couple of this, Donald Duck. So you find that mushroom, it'll trigger this. Sora has a memory. Thank you.
Who's there?
I've come to see the door to this world.
Huh?
This world has been connected.
Well, what are you talking about?
Tied to the darkness. Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Well, whoever you are, stop freaking me out like this. Huh? Well, where did you come from?
You do not yet know what lies beyond the door.
So you're from another world?
There is so very much to learn. You understand so little.
Oh yeah? Well, you'll see. I'm gonna get out and learn what's out there.
A meaningless effort. One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
Right. However, can't. One who knows nothing can't understand nothing, but. I mean, that's the whole point of learning, you know? You learn things to understand things. It's not an easy effort. Alright, so we've collected up the food. Let's go ahead and head in here and save real quick. So far we got 46 minutes into it, level 3. But we still got another thing to do before we actually do the next part, which hopefully I don't fail at. So you grab this crate here. See that cave above us there? That's what we're going for. Yeah, bring this over here. You're going to hit circle. And then jump on it. Okay. Jump. Grab the ledge. A little chest here. That will come in handy. So that erases defense. That'll help with what we're about to have to deal with. I don't remember if we could turn this stuff into her. Okay, so we have to do the race of reach. Yes, but you have to race him in the next bit. It's a challenge, and this is one of the reasons why we save. Is in case we fail, we can try again. So this is for something else later on, but we're gonna just go with Excalibur for now. And they're a little way to the side, because they can't decide what. It's a race.
If I win, I'm captain. And if you win,
I get to share the Palpu with Kairi.
Huh?
Deal? The winner gets to share a Palpu with Kairi.
Wait a minute.
Okay, on my count.
Alright, you're gonna wanna hold forward so you can get a good running start. And of course, he can leap better than you. Yeah! Oh crap, I forgot it's a two-way run. Alright, I guess you can have a chance to redo it. So, let's see if we can actually beat him this time around. So we're gonna try to go a different route this time. Hopefully we can make it quicker. Or not! Crap! He pushed me off. Ah, 0-2. And it won't move forward until you actually beat him, I believe. I hate how this game puts him at an advantage. All right, so we're gonna restart that. I forgot that we could actually do that. So I don't know if it was just to get the item or if it's actually the progress story, but we'll just go with that because that actually helps us too. What was that for? Oh, it was a synthesized material. Alright, so let's go ahead and move forward, shall we? So, 3 mushrooms. Got that. Got the egg. 3 fish. Alright, so we gotta go fill this thing here. Let's attempt to do this quickly because I'm running out of time. Uh-oh. Stop doing things like that. So for those of you who have been watching to this point, I greatly appreciate it and would love to hear feedback or something. I will continue to attempt to record more of my gameplay later on after this. But you filled the bottle up from here. I'm going to end the recording, and I will be back. Thanks for watching.